need somebody like me. In this video, we are going to discuss how to invest during a bear market. So recently, bumababa na naman tayo, guys. We've had a good August, at least sa kalahati ng August, and then nag-correct. Then tuloy-tuloy na naman siya, guys, no? Again, we are correcting because the US markets are correcting again. So the US markets are correcting again, and like I told you, dati pa, matagal na na kapag ang US market nagko-correct, sumusunod talaga yung ating index sa kanila. Now, here's the bad news, guys. Sinabi ko na rin to dati, I think mas magko-correct pa talaga ang US market, in my own opinion only. So right now, year-to-date na nila is negative 21.2%. So nasa bear market territory na naman sila. A few months ago, nasa negative 10% na lang sila eh. And then, nagko-correct na naman sila again due to interest rate hike. They're still fighting inflation, things like that. And additionally, yung mga ganung kasing move ng kanilang government, it might slow down the US corporations. Okay? Na yun yung again magkakusahin ng another drop kapag nag-slow down sila. Kasi right now, if let's say kinumpute ko yung top 6 nila na malalaki, and tingnan ko yung average nila, they are overvalued by around 20%. So, para sa akin, no, if they continue to slow down for the next 2 quarters, di ba? Hindi mag-improve yung kanilang valuation, then I think this market will correct another 20%. At kapag kinumpute ko yan, guys, nandito yan babagsak. Around 270 to 280. So, yun yung estimate ko. If they continue to slow down, magkocorrect pa yan dito, which is the pre-COVID levels nila rito. Na yung level na yan, guys, kapag yan, nag-correct yan dito, na yan yung levels kung nasaan tayo ngayon, guys. Ito yung pre-COVID. So, nandyan tayo ngayon, yung levels na yon. So, tingin ko, babagsak din sila sa ganitong level, pre-COVID, if they continue to slow down for the next 2 to 3 quarters, in my own opinion only. Tayo naman, guys, I think yung stock market natin is, mura na siya. Nagpapamahal lang sa kanya right now is SM Prime Holdings. At least, nag-improve naman yung kanyang fundamentals, okay? Na kapag yun, nakahabol, then maybe, ang best case scenario na nakikita ko on our index is actually sideways, di ba? Then by that time na the US will go up again, sasabay na tayo sa kanila. That's my assumption or speculation for now. Or maybe there's a catalyst in our economy or our stock market moving forward, then maybe mag-decouple tayo. Instead of mag-sideways, maybe we can actually go up. And now going to our topic, guys, wala pa naman tayo technically sa bear market. So, ito yung kahapon negative 12% year to date tayo, na today, down ulit, so, mga negative 13% na to, down year to date, na technically hindi pa naman tayo nasa bear market territory tulad ng US and international, pero malapit na, okay? Ngayon, given that fact na pababa ulit tayo, paano ako nag-i-invest as an investor? Ngayon, if you are new to the market, naiintindihan ko na yung iba, especially mga newbies, takot talaga kayo eh, di ba? Parang nakatakot, parang you're going to invest your money now, you're going to lose it, things like that. So, but that's the reality in life eh. Walang sigurado sa buhay, you always need to take risk, regardless whether the stock market or if you're going to make a certain business, di ba? There's always that risk of being failed. Nandyan lagi yung risk na malulugi ka, okay? In fact, every day there's a lot of business na nalulugi lagi, okay? Mahirap din namang magpayo na, uy, ganito ka dapat mag-invest. Gayahin mo ako, things like that. Kasi magkakaiba naman tayo ng pinanggalingan sa buhay. We have different goals in life. We have different risk appetite. Diba? Kakaiba tayo ng time frame, things like that. Kakaiba tayo ng paniniwala. Okay? So, the best thing I can do in my channel is to show you how I invest, collect the data, then maybe later on, you can visit my channel. Uy! Eto, ganito siya nag-invest dati, and maybe you can get an idea how will you do investing on your own. And that's the best part about investing din kasi. So, if let's say you don't have this up and down in the market, guys, magiging boring yung stock market and it will become a numbers game only. Kung saan, lagi lang mananalo, guys, ay yung magagaling when it comes to financials, di ba? Anything or any professional related to finance or business, sila lang lagi yung magagaling, di ba? If you don't have this up and down or volatility of the market or wala tong greed and fear factor, kumbaga. And this is the reason why, di ba? Hindi lahat ng matatalino, successful investor, okay? And investing, guys, it's not just about the knowledge on the company or kung ano man yung ginagawa mo. It's also about behavioral finance. A big part of it actually is behavioral finance na hindi mo yan talaga na ituturo eh. Di ba? Behavioral finance is something na nakukuha mo based on experience din talaga. Once na na-experience mo na yon, you make your own adjustment, then you can develop slowly. Or yung temperament as an investor na tinatawag na madedevelop mo yan throughout your investing career. Na yan, syempre, di yan basta-basta makuha sa mga kwento-kwentuhan lang, okay? So now I'm going to tell you my rules when it comes to investing on a bear market. And investing in a bear market for me is no different from investing on a bull market. Wala siyang pinagkaiba. And if you are new to my channel, mag-subscribe ka na kasi guys, malapit na ako sa 1K. Okay? And there's a lot of videos in here na makatulong sa'yo. Hopefully. And guys, if you are new to my channel, I don't do market timing. In fact, you go to my website. Link on the description. So, ayan o. Stocks, 99.9%. Stocks, 96.3%. Diba? So, I don't do market timing. In most cases, I'm always stay invested to the market. So, first rule of investing, guys, on a bear market for me is that I stay away from news, stay away from social media, mga groups na yan, because a lot of them, a lot of these outlets will give false information, false data. A lot of them are just noises. Majority ng mababasa nyo sa mga niyan, especially during bear market, are just plain stupidity. And then, after staying away from these bullshits in social medias, forums, and other sheets, the next thing I will do is I will focus on hunting good companies. Okay? That's why I have these fundamentals and valuations na playlist here. And this one is dedicated into analyzing companies, di ba? Ano, sino-sino ba yung mga companies right now that are actually earning, profitable, still growing, di ba? Not those noises out there na kapag ininterpret mo, wala ka rin namang mapapala eh, di ba? So ako, I'll just focus on company performances, individual company performances. I'm going to hunt for those companies na talagang maganda pa rin yung kanilang growth trajectory. Kasi, if I buy them, whether it's bull market or bear market, ayan na, di ba? Will give me this, ooh, look at this, guys. Will give me this nice cash flowing, okay? In my portfolio na based on dividends, okay? So, there are two components to make money in the stock market. Number one is the price appreciation. So, bumili ka ng stock, nag-appreciate in price, binenta mo, then that's a profit for you. Number two, of course, is the dividends, di ba? Ngayon, yung price appreciation na yan, guys, mahirap yan makuha on a bear market. Mahirap yan makuha unless you have a lot of outliers, di ba, in your portfolio na kapag pababa yung market, madami ka pa rin nagtataasan na stock, which happened to me last year. So last year, pababa eh. Taas baba yung stock market last year. Pero, so happened that I have a lot of outliers last year. And this is the reason why I made money last year. Diba? Aside from the dividends na nakolekta ko last year. Ngayon, yung mga price appreciation na yan, hindi talaga yan yung focus ko eh. Diba? Ang goal ko talaga is to buy companies at undervalued prices, companies that are profitable and growing. And then, at some point in the future, alam ko na yung mga companies na nabili ko na yan, magtataasan na lang yan, di ba? Ngayon, ang problema lang yan is hindi ko alam kung kailan sila magtataasan, di ba? Others will try to predict them by doing technical analysis, pero those are all bullshits, di ba? There's no strong evidence that technical analysis can predict anything. They can predict price action, di matagal na sanang merong bilyonaryong mga technical analysis na tao sa mundo, kaso wala. Okay, always remember that. So, ang goal ko lang is pumosisyon on several companies, di ba? By using my own fundamental analysis and valuation analysis. Hunt for those companies na undervalued, profitable, pupusisyonan ko lahat sila and then that's it. I don't know kung sino sa nila yung akyat. There's no way someone will tell you sino akyat, okay? Someone tells you, alam niya kung kailan akyat yan. He's a freaking liar. Ngayon, habang inantay ko silang umakyat, guys, anong nangyayari sa portfolio is that nakukolekta ako ng dividend payments, di ba? Dahil nga bumibili ako ng mga profitable companies na nag-grow in profits, so there's a big possibility na sila, magtataas din sila ng dividend rates year on year or every quarter. And if that happens, you know, this is my dividend snowball. Sa mga newbie yan, no, na hindi pa nakakalam, ano yung sabihin ng TTM, that stands for trailing 12 months. Ibig sabihin, itong 129 na to, ito yung nakolekta kong amount of dividends for the past 12 months, di ba? Let's say for this one, ending September, mula ngayon, including September, then mag-count ka pa ng additional 11 months backwards. Ilan yung dividends na nakolekta ko throughout those time? Yan yun, di ba? You can see here na ito, guys, patas lang to ng patas. Kasi nga, my goal is, again, buy or hunt for companies that are profitable and nag-grow such that they can increase their dividend payments. And ang nangyayari dyan is that, ayan o, makyat to, di ba? And not only that, here's my rule number 3 is that eto, dahil nakaka-receive na ako guys ng dividends, di ba? Yung 129,000 na yan, that's equivalent to 10.7k of dividends per month. So parang sinasabi na rin dito na moving forward, meron ako mare-reinvest na 10,000 to my portfolio every month. So, yung mga 10,000 na yon, di ba, na average na marireceive ko na dividends, ibabalik ko yan on my portfolio. And it's the same thing, di ba? I will do my own fundamentals and valuation analysis. Again, which companies are currently undervalued, profitable, and much better, nag-grow. Hantingin ko yung mga yon, and then, i-invest ko, di ba? Re-reinvest ko yung mga nakukuha kong dividends. And ultimately, guys, it adds up to the compounding effect, di ba? Ayan o. So, ito yung magandang nangyayari din on a bear market or sideways market. Let's say ito, pababa, pataas, pababa, pataas. Is that during this time, guys, no, ito yung time na magandang magpataas ng dividends, di ba? Kasi, guys, kapag ito pumunta na sa time na ganito, yung pataas ng pataas, mahirap na tayong makita niyan ng mga 4 to 5%, di ba? Baka ano na lang yan, ba 3% na lang yan kapag nag-bull markets na. So, habang nasa bear market tayo, ayan, sinasamantala ko na yan, di ba? Habang sideways tayo, I'm going to keep on hunting those companies that are profitable, di ba? Growing and re-invest ko yung dividends ko para once na nag-bull run na ulit to, pataas, chill-chill na lang, di ba? Nakuha ko na yung matas na dividend yield na gusto ko. And, sumusunod na dyan is the price appreciation, okay, na makukuha natin when it comes to investing. So, sa ngayon, ang tumatas is eto, majority is the earnings or the dividend earnings. na bear market or a sideways market. So papatas ka lang ng number of shares, papatas ka ng dividend yield, dividend payments, then later on, mataas na yung dividend yield mo, payments mo, mas mataas, mas malaki na yung marereinvest mo. And then pataas pa yung market. Uy, di ba? Magko-compound yan, guys, nang magko-compound, di ba? Like yung pinakita ko last month, di ba? Yung pinakita ko sa inyo, guys, last month on one of my videos, nung nandito yung market, kapiranggot na lang break even na ako, di ba? For this year, nung nandito yung market, what more kung bumalik yung market dito sa all-time high niya ng taon na to. It's all about your patience or temperament as an investor, di ba? Or minsan yung time horizon mo rin kasi, di ba? Ano ba yung goal mo as an investor? Kasi yung iba, I will invest few years lang, di ba? Well, that's not investing, di ba? So, 10 plus years from now, we're going to go back to this sport and you'll see that, di ba? You're going to ask yourself, ay, putik, di ba? Saan? Nag-invest na lang ako dati. Ganito pala mangyayari sa portfolio mo as an investor, especially this one. Di ba? Kasi ito, guys, it will become unstoppable year on year unless there's an economic collapse in the Philippines. Di ba? Yun lang. Kasi makapektuhan yun yung mga corporate earnings eh. Ngayon, so far, wala akong nakikita eh. First quarter, second quarter, majority of companies are growing. Di ba? More than 85%, baka nga more than 90% of companies are growing for the past 2 quarters. Di ba? Ngayon, third quarter, mag-grow pa rin sila. Ba? Di ba? Then, that's additional or opportunity talaga yan, guys. Imagine, companies in the stock market are growing, pero ang market natin eh pababa due to sentiment only. For me, I see that as an opportunity. Di ba? Especially opportunity to keep on increasing my dividend payments. Di ba? Getting patient. Then later on, pag nag-breakout yung market natin na yan, nag-bull run, uy! Di ba? Pakuya-kuyaway ka na lang, di ba? Things like that. So, that's how I invest on a bear market. And actually, it's no different investing on a bull market. Ganun lang din. Wala silang pinagkaiba. Except that today, we can see a lot of reds. Okay? Pababa. Daming pababa. Except for my dividend yields or dividend payments. So, that's it. That's how I invest on a bear market. Thank you and bye-bye. Like and subscribe.